Now then, me ducks and drakes. Oh, I can't believe we're here. The power is on, and I'm tempting fate, I know, but at least we've got one tune in and a bit of chat and a few hellos. And so good to see you. I really hope you haven't been too badly affected by the weather and that you're staying warm and dry and safe. It's all starting again now, isn't it? Our real lake, not Celia's lake, but the real lake, is back in the field, and John next door, his garden's a swamp, and some of you have been here, I know, but we're underground here in the Zen Den, partially. So So it's kind of like the Zen Den is in a snake pit, and that snake pit is well flooded. But I've got a pump, and every time that pump works, I give thanks. Because I don't use it that often. You know, you flick that switch, you think nothing's going to happen. But it did. It pumped out. Great to see you. Cheers to you all. Feels like I haven't played that for ages, but I know somebody will tell me I have. It's the Hidden Shrine from, or a Hidden Shrine from Time Stand Still. And tune very much, it's almost a duet really between me and the wonderful Inder Goldfinger, percussion player from West Yorkshire. Very, very inspired and inspiring and skillful man. I'm sure you've all got that album, so you can see a picture of him in there. If you haven't, why not? Ah, dear. Okay. Some saxophone. Of the tenor variety. It's the tenor saxophone. Oh, flipping heck. It feels like the weather's going to come inside. Wind is so powerful, wind, isn't it? It's to be respected. Well, weather is, as is the sea, as is nature. But the wind, when you're out in it, it's respect. It's amazing. Maybe I'm amazed. Oh, I love playing that. That was Birchie and the boys, of course, in the background. Not the background, on the track, not in the Zen Den. Simon and Brian. Oh, wonderful. Just get excited hearing them play again. I never finished on that note before. Concert E. I wrote myself a note. It's silly, really. You don't need to know this, but I've started. So, you know, over the years that we've been together doing this down the Zen Den, 180 shows or whatever it is, I've explained to you what I've done. I've gone back to my albums, our albums, and remixed them without me, so I can play the real me live for you. Something to keep us going in the pandemic times. And that one's from a live recording that we made up in Durham Old Town Hall a couple of years ago, recorded by the wonderful Mr. Philu Dahl. And because it's live, when I go back to the multi-tracks, you know, there's a little bit of sax on lots and lots of the mics, the drum mics particularly. So I want to remove me, mute, delete. I can still hear a little bit of me. So I wrote myself a note, try and cover the gaps, you know, because I didn't want you guys to hear an old snake and a new snake. But of course, I can't be thinking about that. I just played it the way I felt it, but I did occasionally hear the old snake. I'm just hoping the new snake is playing better than the old snake. That's what practice is for. It's diminishing returns, isn't it? As you get older, everything. Anything you try and learn, it's diminishing returns. But I still hope I'm getting a little bit better every year. Tiny, tiny, teensy. Don't shoot me down. I wish I'd just set myself up for a... Oh, shut up, snake. Anyway, look, let's get on to more interesting things. I did... I did threaten you with a bit of Gareth and a bit of Chris. It's really impossible. So Marina was asking. It's absolutely impossible. Unless you've got $1 billion kit and technical stuff. It's impossible to play remotely live and not be all over the place as far as the time goes. So Chris and Gareth will be joining me from the hard drive. They record their bits at home in their own studios, send it to me with the gaps for snakeisms, and then we stitch it together. So it feels live. I feel their spirits. I feel their presence, but it's not live in real time. Sadly. Hopefully in our lifetimes there won't be another pandemic, but if there were to be one, by then we'd probably be able to, it'd be sorted so that we could actually play. You know, I could be playing with old what's his name from Los Angeles, and we could be in real time, but not yet. You get that latency, ba-doop. It's not so bad when you're talking. It's a bit disconcerting, but when you're trying to play music, forget it. So, joining me from the past and from the hard drive, this is the wonderful Gareth Moulton. We're going to be together in just a few weeks at the Ropery Hall, March the 27th. So, hope we'll see some of you there. I'm sure I will. Right, reset, reset, reset. Reset, reset. So much to think about. Okay. Where are you?
Gently does it for a change. I used to think you were just like a mountain range, with your big boots stomp where small men fear to tread. I can't hardly believe what my eyes just read. Well, a few years ago, you've been on this road so long. I hear them building a highway to take you home. They say you can't travel anymore, but you got the key to a new front door. We'll be glad to know you once said it all, but here where you stand, you got so far to fall. When a few years ago, you've been on this road so long. I hear them building a highway to take you. Difficult, dangerous, I'm damned if I lie. Well, we all pay the price when we raised your ante so high. Well, a few years ago, you've been on this road so long. I hear them building a highway to take you. So long, I hear them building a highway to take you home. Gently does it for a change. I used to think you were just like a mountain range, with your big boots stomp where small men to tread. I can't hardly believe what this letter said. Well, a few years ago, you've been on this road so long. I hear them building a highway to take you home. Well, a few years ago, you've been on this road so long. I hear them building a highway to take you
. Yes, the delectable, the one and only, GarethMoulton.com. We've got a few shows in the diary, and he's also out on the road doing the wonderful play Fly Half. You've got to catch that if you possibly can, as well as catching the two of us together. Ah, and it's so emotional every time I revisit those recordings, and it's just as powerful as the first time that we hooked up for those virtual duets. Because in those early days, that was all we could do. All we could do. And I still love them. So yeah, I think it might have been referred to in the chat. I don't know. I imagine it might have been. But I can officially verify that Liz and Ron did get hitched and seem pretty happy about it. took them a full week, mind you. So I thought it would be appropriate to play a beautiful melody written by the wonderful Jim Diamond called The Road to Florida Gary. Multiple reasons to play this. I love it. Celia loves it. And Liz and Ron love it. In fact, I believe they walked down, not they, he was already there waiting nervously. But Liz waltzed slowly down the aisle to this tune. Road to Florida, Gary. Reset, reset, reset. Reset. I'm concentrating so hard here. Don't distract me. Happy days ahead for you, Liz and Ron. Wishing you a peaceful and calm married life together. Yeah, oh, I'm glad you chose that to skip down the aisle to. So there's a little trio of haikus coming from one of our haiku masters, Mr. Mike Cole. Him of Windy Filey. And you need the background to this, just to remind you, or in case you weren't here last week. Last week I played a Smokey Robinson tune. And it was one that I did live with him on the Jonathan Ross Show. Tears of a Clown. But I couldn't remember over the last 20 years whether we actually ever really did play it with him or whether it was a false memory, because I remembered him coming onto the Jonathan Ross show where I was a member of the Steve Naive house band for a couple of years. And we learnt the song and we didn't know if he was going to sing it or not because he had a bit of a croak in the old throat. See my little pantomime croak there. And I couldn't remember if we ever did play it or not. But I found it. I found a recording of it, so it proved. And Mike was inspired. He said he couldn't let the croaky smoky challenge go unanswered. So this trio is called False Memory, ? Jonathan Ross Show. A croaky smoky on stage. Performance in doubt. Snake to the rescue. Band plays him his top 10 hits. The problem solved. How, you may all ask? Tunes help you breathe more easily. Snake's fake memory. Very good, mate. He must have been up late doing that one. Those three. Excellent behaviour. I thought it was an appropriate time to remind you also that Mike is the main keeper of the database, aided and abetted by Sandman Richard. And that's normally kept up to date. So if you go to the news page on snakedavis.rocks, you'll find all the tunes that we've ever played down the Zen Den. 400 and odd different ones, I believe. All listed there. What I played each week, and then you can go back and check things out if you have special favourites and all that kind of thing. So that was a labour of love too, must have been. And there's some fun quizzes on there as well. All on the news page. Right, what's coming up now? More whistle. You might think I'm just picking the whistle up again, but it's got a different body because we're in a different key. And we're going to move on to the threatened appearance by the wonderful Chris Bannister, who is also popping over to Barton-on-Humber's Ropery Hall. And that's just, it's only six sleeps time, isn't it? Or was it seven sleeps? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Six sleeps time. Or was it seven? Tonight, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Seven sleeps until Chris comes to the Ropery Hall, Barton-on-Humber, nestling in the shadow of the Humber Bridge, if it's even still there by then. And that's a week today. 7:30, let's all meet there. Cheers to that. And I absolutely love this piece of Chris's. It's from his album, The Unicorn and Other Stories, or Other Tales. ChrisBannisterMusic.com, all the details. And it's called The Prentice Boy. If we can find him, let's rifle through the hard drive. Yes, mate.
Here we go, Snake. This is Prentice Boy. I'll see you out on the road soon, I hope.
I hope so. You will.
Trader, I do belong. To sail the seas around and around. I had not sailed the league but one when I fell in love with a young woman. Whack for la la day, whack for la la day. my captain I then did go. And I told him of my sad grief and woe. I love a girl as I love my life. What would I give if she was my wife? Whack for la la day, whack for la la day. Begun, you foolish and simple boy, to love a girl you can ne'er enjoy. For she has sweethearts on land and sea, and she'll be married for you are free. Whack for la la day, whack for la la day. Never mind, I'll go and I'll try. Perhaps she might be fancy eye. Perhaps she might be fancy eye. Although I'm but a prentice boy. Whack for la la day, whack for la la. So I bought her ribbons and I bought her gloves, and I safe conveyed them unto my love. And in taking them she was no way shy, although they came from a prentice boy. Whack for la la day, whack for la la. Cheeks as red as roses, his honor kind and free. She said, dear youth, the fair I wed, I'll surely marry thee. So come all young men, where'er you be, you never flirt your love in low degree. Love a girl as you love your life, and when you're leaving, make her your wife. Whack for la la day, whack for la la day, whack for la la day, whack for la la day.
You will see me later, mate. You'll see me next week. Can't wait. Treading the boards. Boy, how we missed it. There's loads of gigs. I wrote them down so I could tell you. I can't remember when I had so many gigs in the diary that I wouldn't be able to remember them all. After being with Chris next week in March, there's millions. Well, not millions. A handful. Glasburn, that's over not far from Huddersfield. Also in West Yorkshire. Glasburn Arts, lovely arts centre with classic sax solos. Loads of gigs with them March the 12th. Down in Cardiff, March 25th. Bramham the 26th, but it's all sold out. Then the Southern Tour, Southend on March the 30th. Cobham, beautiful gig in, not the Southend is not a beautiful gig, it is a wonderful gig too, right by the sea. But a lovely gig in Cobham, that's Cobham, Kent. St. Mary Magdalene Church, perfect venue on March 31st. April the 1st, we're down in the spring Havant. Where's Jo Preston these days? She on board? I don't know. I haven't seen her for a while. Anyway, that's her territory. And then we finished that tour on April the 2nd in Wimborne, a really kind of old school theatre called the Tivoli. I know some of you are coming there, mentioning no names, John and Joan, Ron and Liz. Happy days. No need the whistle anymore. Need the stick. Simple folk flute. Stick of blackwood with a few holes in. Very simple. Yeah. Don't know what I'm going to play on it. Oh, I know. Carrick Fergus, traditional, beautiful Irish air. And then a piece of mine called the Shannon Pint. Goodbye, folk flute. So you all seem pleased to see Fakey back last week. Don't know where he'd been. So I've had him working again. I don't think we've ever done this one before. Certainly not in this weird way. Ray Charles tune. I've slightly retitled it. It's now called Fake These Chains. I know you'll sing along. Horn is cold. Just going to breathe some warm air down it. Sounds like the sea. Where are you, fixies? Take these chains from my heart and set me free. You've grown cold and no longer care for me. All my faith in you is gone, but the heartaches linger on. Take these chains from my heart, set me free. Take these tears from my eyes, let me see. Oh, just a spark of the love that used to be. If you love somebody new, let me find a new love too. Oh, take these chains from my heart, set me free. Fakies. They look quite excited and like they're enjoying themselves there. And rightly they should on such a great song. It was a thought that just came to me. That might be a nice way to do that song. I used to do that with Jim Diamond as well. I think it's on that CD I burned for you, Celia. It is, I know it is. I used to enjoy that. We did a whole bunch of touring, just he and I, which was usually great, sometimes a nightmare, for various logistical reasons. But yeah, a lot of fun. Great spirit. Mr. Jim Diamond. Oh. And Ray Charles, of course. Finally, one of the chickens laid an egg today. We've got 7 or 8 of them. Milked an egg for as long as I can remember. I don't think it's been an egg in February. It's so humiliating going to the co-op to buy eggs when you've got chickens. What's that saying? It's like, why have a dog and wag your own tail? No, I think I've got that wrong. Oh, let's swap saxes. I'll treasure that single egg. We'll quarter it and make it last for 4 days. It's all been slow dancing mostly so far, doesn't it? You want to get one stomper in before we draw the curtains over the proceedings? Yes, I think we do. Guys and girls, right after this I'm going to have a little bit of Devon Blue, my new favourite cheese, and read all that you've been chatting about, because you chat too fast. I can't flipping keep up with you guys. I'm thinking about what notes to press. Right, I could let you into a secret now. Because I'm all on my own tonight. Sally and Joe swanned off to see Uncle Mark. I've never done a stream on my own down the den. I was absolutely petrified. I mean, they did say I could ring them. the team if necessary, and Joe did leave me a lot of instructions. We did do a test stream with him watching in at 2 o'clock, and I did really look at my instructions and read down my list. So they still get big thanks. Big thanks to Joe and Sally. And Mike Cole wrote me this haiku, just in case it all went wrong and I needed cheering up. Because the studio, we've got the habit of calling it the Zen Den, which it is the Zen Den, but its official title is the Heianji, Temple of Peace and Calm. And so here's his haiku. Heianji, priceless, the treasure of Lincolnshire, our own Wootton Hoo. Our own Wootton Hoo, that's the village that we're in. Wharton. Do you get it? Thank you, Mike. I didn't need it in the end, but it was lovely to have it. So a big thanks to for Jim Diamond, who gave us the Road to Florida, Gary. Obviously the wonderful, amazing Chris Bannister. And we'll all be together, won't we, with Chris down the Ropery Hall next Sunday. So there'll be no stream. Well, I won't apologise, but just all meet down the Ropery. No, if it's too far to go, then I am sorry that I won't be with you next Sunday. But most of you will make it, won't you? But back the week after, which is March the 6th, and the week after that, and the week after that, back down the Zen Den, Heianji. Fun and frolics. And big thanks to the delectable Gareth Moulton. 27th of March, Ropery Hall. And Birchie and the boys, Simon, of course. So, I'll see you all soon. Take extra special care. I'll see you before we go. Let's finish with The Dream. I know you love that one. I love it too. Love it, love it, love it. But where is it? I think I've found it. Yeah, I think so. We'll find out. I could always make it up. Oh, Oh, good job I end with that one. Puffs me out. Guys. Take special care this week. Be extra kind to each other and honestly, go steady. Don't go out unless you need to. Mind you, the weather's coming in. Thank you so much for being here. Spread the word. Tell your friends, family, pets, colleagues, enemies. Thank you so much for your donations. Optional. Always appreciated. Every time I look at the camera and the laptop, I think, you guys made that happen. It's amazing. So happy to see you, as always. Take great care. See, if I don't see you next week, I'll see you back down here March the 6th, fortnight today. Take good care. Thank you.